Dr. Drew, every weeknight, 9 Eastern on HLN.
I was 3 years old, and I was awakened by the crushing weight of my father, who was drunk, on top of me. I, in re-experiencing this quite later in life, felt my shoulder go numb, the side of my face go numb. I could smell the stale, sickening smell of old alcohol. You know, when somebody drinks every day, the alcohol just comes out of their pores.
That acetone smell.
Yeah, that terrible smell. My hip went numb. He was in a state of arousal. It kind of fractured me in that moment. A part of me broke off and just tried to escape. You know, just you separate. Parts of yourself just get shut off because you're no longer safe in the world. I remember when I heard about all those young men with Sandusky, and it just hurt my heart so much because I just thought, you know, I know how it is to go through your life and never feel safe in your own body. That is a line that once it's crossed is so hard to repair. I remember I went to a retreat once, and they said, well, what would you like to get out of this weekend? And I said, I'd like to feel safe. I didn't even know I'd been sexually abused at that point. And two women came up and said, was your dad an alcoholic or something like that? And I said,
they could sense it?
Yeah. And they said, you think something happened? And I said, yeah, maybe. And they said, yeah. When you used the word safe, we know what that's about.
Kids that go through that become good victims later. Was there other victimization, or did you repeat the traumas in any way?
Fortunately, most of the time I escaped, but I would go places with men or people I didn't know. One time it turned out not very well. This fellow had been drinking. I didn't smell it, you see, because it was familiar to me, so I was attracted to it. And he kept showing pictures of his fiance. And he said, come on, just come up to my room with me for a minute. I'm going to get my jacket, and we'll go out and join the others. He jumped on me in his room. It was going to be a rape, but I fought him off. And I was so traumatized, and I fought, and I had bruises and mascara running, and I was so ashamed that I couldn't tell anyone. I thought it was all my fault. You see, this is the thing that, you know, we take the shame on ourselves, and the shame colors everything we do.